Hello guys, in this video we'll be looking at the Resun 25 watt air pump. Now let's do the unboxing. Upon opening the box, you'll be greeted by the instruction manual. This is me pretending to read it. Now enough reading, let's see what else we have in the box. So you also get this hose, short hose, and an 8-way splitter. Nice. Now moving on to our main attraction. Wow, this thing has a rotary switch. It's like a volume knob. I like the texture and the shape of it. Now here's the overall look of the item. It's mainly aluminum with some hard plastics on the front and sides. It's got four sturdy rubber feet to minimize vibrations. The label says max airflow is 54 lpm. And the pump weighs 1.65 kilos as per my Chinese weighing scale. Now let's check its power consumption. But before that, here's an important note. When operating the pump, please connect the supplied hose and splitter. This will minimize the buzzing sound. The next clip will show the difference between without the hose and with the hose attached. Now on to the watt meter test. Here you can see that I removed the hose so that you'll be able to see the changes in the airflow as I turn up and turn down the knob. So upon switching it on, the initial reading is 5.3 watts. And as I turn up the knob, the wattage increases as well as the airflow. The pump was able to reach 25 watts as advertised. Good job, Resun. So the same thing happens when I turn it down. Both the wattage and airflow decreases. Let's try to hook it up to my central air system. By the way, this central air system is an easy build. But if you would like to see how I did mine, just let me know in the comments below and I'll try to do a short video of it. So on this side, I have three layers of 10-gallon tanks. That's two on each layer. And here's an empty layer for now. Here I have connected another pipe across to where I have three ponds. Sorry, there's two ponds for now. I'm still patching up the leaks of the third pond since they're only made of tarpaulin. So a brief history of the company Resun. These guys have been around for 31 years, so they specialized in product development and manufacturing of aquatic, pond, reptile, and pet products. The watt meter says it's averaging at 5.6 watts, which is the lowest setting. So in total, the pump is supplying air to 13 air stones, 5 DIY bottom filters, and 2 sponge filters. So how much will it cost me to run the pump 24/7? Let's do some math. The average power consumption is 5.6 watts multiplied by 24 hours and you'll get 134.4 watts. Then you multiply by 30 days, that's 4032 watts. Now to convert that to kilowatts, we need to divide it by 1000 and you'll get 4.032 kilowatts. Now multiply by 1150 pesos, this is the current rate per kilowatt as of writing, you'll get this amount. It's about 47 pesos. So that's an additional 47 pesos to our monthly electric bill that, of course, my wife pays. But if you were running this at full capacity, just multiply 47 by 5 to get the monthly cost at 25 watts. Now you may think that using a 25 watt pump is overkill for my setup, but I have plans to expand my hobby / small business. Anyway, Resun has this other model, so it's also rated at 25 watts and it looks beefier, but I prefer the aesthetic look of this one. Also, this purrs like a cat during its operation. But the main selling point of this pump is the adjustable airflow. So this saves me some money since it's not running at full capacity all the time. And I don't have to buy another pump with a higher capacity just in case I'll be adding more tanks and ponds. So with this, I can easily go from 5 to 25 watts when needed, then back to 5 watts again using the same air pump. But I also want to know your thoughts on this. Was this a good buy or a bad one?